Hi everyone! Today we will discover some very interesting features of the Picotech USB's oscilloscope. Yes, this is one of my audio analyzers, very useful. What we have here? Dummy load, 2x 8 ohm 100 watt, and Picoscope 2204. Yes, the bandwidth of this oscilloscope is only up to 10 megahertz, but for audio signals is too much. This set works on the Windows PC with the Picoscope 6 software. Let's get started. My dummy load has two integrated 10-to-1 probes for each of the two oscilloscope channels. Each channel has a low and high impedance probe, which is selected by this switch. I did it so that the dummy load was connected directly to the oscilloscope, not via a clutter of wires. This is a diagram of one channel of my artificial dummy load. On the input, there are two 60 ohm 50 watts resistors connected in parallel with the switch S1 to get either 8 or 60 ohms. Then there is a banana socket for connecting a multimeter with which we will monitor the signal level or calibrate the attenuation of the probes in oscilloscopes. We already have two probes, 10-to-1, connected in parallel to DVM socket. The probes can be selected by using the IS2 switch. The low impedance probe can also be used as a low power output or headphone output. For example, I have a Soviet vintage amplifier, Lorta 50U202S. This amplifier was very popular in the countries of the Eastern Bloc in the early 90s. It is characterized by an almost armored military casing and a rather pleasant sound. We'll measure it right now with a Picoscope oscilloscope. Previously, I calibrated the system to get the same indication as the old sound technology brand audio analyzer, like this module. I set the oscilloscope resolution to 10.5 bits here. Then to make the results for 1 kHz almost identical to the ST1700B analyzer, I set the time base to 10 milliseconds. I mean, not for 1 millisecond, so several waveforms could be seen. I adjusted the level to 1 watt, refer for 8 ohms, refer to 8 ohms, AI 2.83 ohms is very closed. And I set for the FFT Blackman Harris window. For better response of the measurement. So now we have the measurements which was obtained from this scope and dummy load. Here's ACRMS, this 2.876 volts on the multimeter looks like that. It's very close. And here we have signal to noise ratio in dB, total harmonic distortion between 0.05 and refer to 1.086 watt. Okay, if you want to see the frequency range and frequency characteristics of the tested amplifier or filters, just change time base to 2 milliseconds or 5 milliseconds and turn on the peak detection mode in FFT analysis menu. The internal generator of the oscilloscopes has a sweep function. Set the frequency range and that's it. Here is the generator and observe this signal here. This is frequency response of this amplifier. Now let's see what max power this amplifier gives to a load of 8 ohms. We'll increase the power with the attenuator in the amplifier until the first distortion. Okay. Now we have 1 watt. 1.7. 2.7. 4.3. 14.72 volts refer to 8 ohms, which give us 28 watts per channel for 1 kilohertz. For maximal power, amplifier indicates overload. And now measurements refer to 50 milliwatts for 1 kilohertz. I mean the signal to noise ratio is 66.12 dB, refer to DIN 45500 norm, European hi-fi norm. It's working. Of course, such a device will not have parameters such as audio precision ATS analyzers, but it is an interesting cheap alternative to more expensive systems. The instrument calculates the spectrum from the samples and all of the measurements are counted from it. In the video I omitted all of theory related to sampling, signal processing, Nyquist, etc. Guys, thanks for your attention and watching. Thank you. See you soon.